Today we will be doing MS Excel's formula and function. Let us see what are formula and function of MS Excel. First of all, let us understand what they are. Formula is an expression which calculates the value of a cell. See, if A1 and A2 are having values and I want to add them, then I can use a formula. A formula always starts with is equal to sign, and A1 plus A2 will give me the answer 5. Okay, what is function? Function is predefined formula which are already present in Excel and you just have to use them. Like sum is a function already given. If I want to add them, then I can write is equal to sum and select the range from A1 to A2, and it will give me the final summation as 5. What all can a MS Excel formula contain? It can contain functions, references, operators and constants. What are they? Functions are again predefined, like pi will give me the pi value 3.14. Multiplication and caret both are operators, like addition, division, all that kind of operators. Caret means raised to the power. Here it means a2, whatever value is stored in reference a2, raised to the power 2. A2 is the reference and 2 is a constant. Now here you can say I am having 4 values in 4 different cells, and if I use only one kind of operator, that is I am adding A1 plus A2 plus B1, that is I have used only plus operator, then it is a simple formula. Okay. And second, if I am using different kind of operators, that is A1 plus A2 multiply and division, I have used 3 kind of operators, addition, multiplication and subtraction, then it is said to be a compound formula. Now what is concatenation? If I am having text value in the cell and if I want to add them or join them together, then I can use it by saying A1 and this will bring this both the values together. Okay. These are the different mathematical operators that you can use in Excel. These are the different logical operators that you can use in Excel. Equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than, equal to. What is the order of the operation? If you are using a compound formula, then whatever is written in the parenthesis is executed first, then exponent, then multiplication, division, then addition, then concatenation, and then the logical operators. So let us see in this formula what we have done is we have concated B5 with the rest of the items. Concatenation will happen, concatenation will happen last. A1 plus parenthesis will be first, so first A2 will be multiplied by B2. And then after, division happens to be before addition, so it will be divided by 2. And then after, A2 will be added, and then after, concatenation would happen. So the output would be something. School 19. Okay. Let us understand relative cell reference, absolute and mixed cell reference. When we say relative cell reference, it means that the formula is based on the relative position of the cell. Let us see it through an example. I am having A1, B1 and I have 2 columns like this. Suppose I make a formula that A1 has to be multiplied by A2. And now I want that this formula should be copied. So when I will copy the formula and reach to the next value, you can see for this he has taken the relative position. Since over here I am multiplying this 2, for this cell he has multiplied the B2 and B1. Here it will multiply A3 and B3. Here it will multiply A4 and B4, so the relative position changes. Now let us see what is a circular reference. Let us see, like A1 is having value 25 And in A2, I am trying to write that I want to add A1 and A2 and multiply by 3. That is, in A2 itself, I am referring to cell A2. Means when a formula refers to its own cell, directly or indirectly, then it is said to be a circular reference. Now let us see what are the different kind of errors that can be thrown when I am using formulas. Like suppose if I am having a very huge number as an answer and I try to store it in a smaller column, then it will throw me this error. Let us see how. I want to say multiply multiplied by this, okay, enter. Still my column is big, so it is showing. I made it even small. You can see that it is showing me #sign because there is no enough space for it to be displayed. If I make it bigger, it will show me the value back again. Second is the value error. Value error is generated when I try to use a illegal data or illegal value. So if I try to divide 4 by 0, dividing anything by 0 is an error. So it is giving me a division. Division here is the division by 0 error. It is called a value error. Reference error. Suppose if I am using over here 25 multiplied by this, and by any means if I am going to delete this column, I am deleting this cell. My cell is deleted, so it is not finding the reference A1. It needed to be multiplied with a number and A1 is not found. The earlier A1 is not found, so it is giving me a reference error over here. I had referred A1, it cannot find. Now what is a cell? Cell range. Like suppose if I have written some numbers and I want to give them a name, maybe I want to use it for something. Cell is basically a rectangular area of contiguous cells or cells which are written continuously or without any space between them. Suppose I am having this data and I want to, this is a range. This is said to be a range including B1 to, it is C4. B1 to C4 is the range. Starting from first year, that is B1 cell, to the last, that is C4 cell, is said to be the range. I can give a name to the range. I can say select, right click and select define name. It allows me to give it a name. I am giving it range. Okay. I already have something called as range. So I call RANG. This is the name given to the range. Now for a formula or something, I can use it. If I am using a function, I can use the range that I want to use, RANG, and I want to do addition of everything, it will give me. Thank you. So in relative reference, we saw that here, as I have taken A1 and B1 as two cells which are to be multiplied and their multiplication to be stored in C, and if I am going to drag and drop it, it is going to multiply, here it will make it B2 and A2 multiplied, here A3 and B3 multiplied, here A4 and B4 multiplied, and hence the value changes over here. You can see it is multiplying this 2, this is multiplying this 2, and this is multiplying this 2. This is a relative reference. Then what is an absolute reference? In an absolute reference, I want that one of the row or the column should remain as it is, and or I want that the value is not changed when I drag and drop the formula. Let us see how this can be achieved. I want that the value should remain as A1 multiplied by B1 only, even if I drag the formula. For that, I'll have to say that keep the column constant, keep the row constant over, and with a dollar sign, keep the column and row constant, means do not change it. This is achieved by a dollar sign. So I have changed this to an absolute reference. Now it is, when I drag it, you can see the value remains same, because now it is still multiplying the first two values, that is A1 and B1. Here still it is multiplying A1 and B1, and here also it is still multiplying A1 and B1. That is, relatively the cell's value did not change. Now then, what is a mixed reference? Mixed reference means one of the value I want that the column should change, but the row or the other value should remain as it is. So for one I will take relative, for the other I will take absolute. It means mixture of both of them. What should I do in that case? I'll be taking a mixture of both of them. So I'll remove this absolute reference for A1. That is, I'll remove the absolute reference. So A1 over here is using the relative reference, and B1 is using the absolute reference. Now let me drag and drop it, what the formula would do. You can see that it is taking this A2, but this B1 remains same. Simultaneously or similarly, here A3 comes, but B1 remains same, and here A4 came multiplied by B1, which remains absolutely referred. Understood?